these last 4 years? Did you miss you? Did you ever look at something going on in the news and go, you know what the situation needs? Little Barack Obama.
I've said this before. People would ask me, knowing what you know now, do you wish like you had a third term? And I used to say, you know what? If I could make an arrangement where I had a stand-in, a front man or front woman, and they had an earpiece in, and I was just in my basement in my sweats, mm-hmm. looking through the stuff, and then I could sort of deliver the lines, but somebody else was doing all the talking and ceremony. Wow. I'd be fine with that because
yes, well, Reverend T.D. Hale is scheduled to be our guest today. He's seen Donald Trump walking down Pennsylvania Avenue toward the White House, but a coffin was sitting in front of him. Now, he really believed that Trump was going to win the election.
I went too far, I made a mistake, and I was wrong.
The apology came just hours after the images went viral. Kathy Griffin holding a bloodied likeness of President Donald Trump's head.
The image is too disturbing. I understand how it offends people.
It was not enough for the president. Tweeting this morning, Kathy Griffin should be ashamed of herself. My children, especially my 11-year-old son, Barron, are having a hard time with this.
The Obamas are staying in D.C. for 2 years after the president leaves office.
He's about to go from commander-in-chief to couch commander.
You, Chuck Todd. What am I going to do in D.C. for 2 years?
You've got a real dilemma, Mr. President.
I can't go every day, can I?
What you like better, these or these?
Joe, they're the same.
They capture different moods.
If we were to count the kings, what sign would God give us to help us know where to begin counting the kings? President number 38 is known to be Gerald Ford, but that was not the name he was born with. His original last name was King. When he was a baby, his parents divorced, and when his mother remarried, he took the name of his stepfather. He could have been a King, his biological father's last name, but he was renamed Ford.
God bless you.
The man who could have been a king was renamed Ford. And a ford is a place in a river, a stream, or other body of water where people may cross over. I believe Gerald Ford is the dividing line, and the presidents after him are the kings, referred to by Revelation 17, verse 10.
But I assume the presidency under extraordinary circumstances never before experienced by Americans. I am acutely aware that you have not elected me as your president by your ballots. But there is a higher power, by whatever name we honor him, who ordains not only righteousness but love, not only justice but mercy. And let brotherly love purge our hearts of suspicion and of hate.
Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up.
And the beast that was and is not, even he is the eighth, and is of the seventh, and goeth into perdition.